Sean, is that as bad as it gets for you on a personal level, leading 16-0 and then throwing the game away?
I think it's as bad as it gets for us as a group. We were terrible, you know, in 16 points up. And then we just wouldn't tackle. We showed very little resilience. We weren't very clever what we were trying to do. So there's obviously something that we need to rectify. There's problems. So we need to rectify them, and it must be very quick that we do rectify them.
When you're leading 16-0 and dominating, John, does that cut that much deeper than that you just collapse like that? No. And everything you've done right?
Yeah, well, I think that's the word, is collapse. And we did collapse, you know. We just folded. And we went from, what was it, 36 minutes, 16-0. Conceded two tries just before, in two sets. And I think we conceded two tries in three sets in the second half. So in five sets we conceded four tries, and the game was just turned on its head. They grew in confidence, they ran harder than us, they tackled harder than us, and they looked as if they wanted to win more than us, to be totally truthful. So it's a very, very difficult day for everyone, the players, the staff, and the club, basically.
I know the game's just finished, John, but what do you put that turnaround down to? Obviously, we know momentum is a big thing in rugby league.
I don't think it's a technical, I think it's an attitudinal thing. So, you know, because it's nothing to do with what game plan you've got, what structure you're playing, etc., etc. We couldn't tackle anybody. You know, for those five, well, I think they scored six tries in 11 sets. And during that time, nobody should be scoring six tries in 11 sets at elite level. And there were. And basically, a lot of them were just picking up from dummy half and carrying very strongly and playing the ball quick and just getting on the back of that. So we've a lot of work to do in this next week. I don't want the season to end with a whimper, but that was certainly a whimper.
This is now the third defeat on the bounce, John. You're going into the playoffs with the worst form the club has had this season. What's the mood like?
Well, the mood's terrible. You know, we can't be dishonest. We've got to be honest. And the mood's terrible. And that's the challenge that we've got to do. We've got to rescue it within 6 days, because we're playing 6 days. I believe we play Batley, is that right?
Batley away, yeah.
So in 6 days, we've got a monumental challenge after they've been to Halifax and beaten Halifax.
You kept the same 17 that narrowly lost to Widnes last week, John. What were the reasons behind that? Did you feel that you were going to give them a second chance?
When we lost last week, I think it was easy to identify why we lost. It's not as easy to identify why we've lost this week, so this one's causing more problems. But I want players who want to play for this club, and that will be one of the questions that I ask them on Tuesday, you know, and that will be part of the selection process.
You've got 6 days to turn it around, John. How much of a challenge is that going to be?
It's a massive challenge for the club and the players. It's a massive challenge for us as a group, us as a performance group. It's a massive challenge, but it's one that we've got to embrace, you know. I'm so disappointed that our resilience levels were nil. You know, we just collapsed, and it is a mystery, and we've got to attempt to identify why and then correct it.
You knew Whitehaven, obviously, John, they were playing do or die. They had to win, yeah, and hope the result went their way, which it has done. Obviously, as you've mentioned in the pre-match to me, Lewis Jouffre, Lachlan Walmsley, you know, those players really stood up today.
They were very good. I mean, they looked awful for 35 minutes because we were dominating them. But then for 45 minutes, they've put us to the sword. There's no doubt about that. So, you know, to go from 16-0 and then concede 36 unanswered points, six tries, you're not going to win anything if you're going to concede six tries. And some of it is down to willing to make small efforts to either get back in the defensive line or to work with your mate to cover for it. You know, one of the saddest things for me was when Eldon Myers made that break, and he's waiting for somebody to get to dummy half to play the ball. Well, that's not a team with great desire, enthusiasm and energy. You know, it's a team that's going through the motions, and I think that's what we've done.
You've mentioned, John, an attitude issue, an attitude problem. Is that something that's just become apparent this afternoon, yeah, or have you detected that in other games this year?
No, I mean, we play at Toulouse, and we got what everybody's getting against Toulouse. We lost last week by 1 point, so this has come as a shock to me. It's come as an absolute shock to me. You know, I was stood on the sideline not believing what I was seeing from this group of people. So with a lot of soul searching to do, and it's going to be a very tough week.
Obviously, you've lost home advantage now. You're going away to Batley next Saturday. Obviously, from a club point of view, that's got to be a disappointment. Because
we've lost home advantage twice. We lost it last week from winning position. This week, I would suggest 16-0 gives you every chance of winning the game. And we've lost third place twice. So it's very, very upsetting.
How close was Evan Skerr to featuring, John, this afternoon?
I mean, that's a selection thing. I mean, let's analyse what's happened on the field of play. Not to worry about who we're going to pick next week. We need to look back about what's happened just out there.
John, I was at Sheffield on the opening day, and I think it's fair to say you knew that that was a really terrible performance from minute 1 to 80. But as you kind of touched on with Mick, the fact that for 35 minutes, not only were you 16, look, but what even barely had a sniff? Does that make it all the more, like, unbelievably shocking that it just sort of flipped on its head like that?
Yes, it is. It is. It's it, absolutely. You know, and as I said, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. And I feel really sorry for the marketing people who've managed to get a great crowd in. You know, and if somebody's returned from not seeing Bradford Bulls for a long time and seeing that, they'll wonder what we're showing up. And we haven't done ourselves justice. We as a performance group have not done ourselves justice.
And obviously you said they were kind of getting through it well. There was 6 scores and 11 sets, particularly through the middles. It was just a case of just banging through the middles every time and scoring.
Right.
I mean, that's got to be an area of real concern. It's going to be the big focus in training.
Well, that's my point about it's not a structure. It's an attitude thing to just run through as they did. You know, and some of the tries, frankly, were embarrassing.
Yeah, and obviously there's not many, if any, sort of good points. Obviously Ben got the 2 tries, and he looked a threat whenever he tried to get on the ball. Is that, we've talked about the Wallace lads that you brought in that have done a good job. We haven't talked that much about Ben, but Ben is an attacking for the, like you said, the lads weren't willing when Eldon Myers ran at the end, but in general, Ben seemed probably one of the most ones to get on the ball all afternoon. And
yeah, I don't want to, because this is a group thing. And I include the coaches and all the staff in that as well. This is a group thing, and we've got to solve the problems in 6 days. And the only way that people can measure if we have will be if we go to Batley and play something like, because that was nothing like us.
And just a final one from me, John. Obviously, Mick said obviously you lost the home advantage now to Batley. Obviously, crowd totally understandably quite irate and get quite angry at some of what they saw in the second half. In that sense, does that give, not an advantage, but in a way, the fact that you're away from Oldsall next week, is that a tiny benefit in any way?
No, we wanted to be at home. We wanted to be at home, and we failed. And twice we've had opportunities to nail that, and twice we've failed.
What was the dressing room like at the end?
Well, we've just had quite an in-depth, forthright, sort of 15 minutes or so. So it's not good.
Is it fair to say that players' jerseys are potentially...
I don't want to conjecture on that, Mick. I want to look back about this, and we need to just regather ourselves.